She said in her subconscious, "Oh my son, if you only know what you have." How many of the mothers knows that? Sometimes you look at your child and you say, "Whoa, if this child only knows what he has." She came as a mother. She looked at his potential. She looked at his ability. She looked at what he has to offer. Right now, Jesus is looking at your potential. He looks at everything within you. And the only thing that he says to you is, whatever I will say from today forward, just do it. If I say, lay your hands on the sick, do it. If I say, bless your neighbor, do it. If I say, take your pastor on a holiday, do it. When I say, forgive your husband, do it. When I say, stay in this church until I come, do it. When he said to you, bring somebody to church, not only when it's family and friends, they want, that's the main thing in America, I see. That the churches is packed out. So for the rest of the year, they can go to hell. Is that so?
No.
Is that so? So next week is family and friends day, you know? Hey, Dr. Brown. Dr. McGowan. I think Dr. Brown is speaking about me. The reason why I say that, because we want to invite them only when it's an occasion like that.
Amen.
But for the rest of the year, they are dying without God.
That's right. Amen.
Why don't you make family and friends day every Sunday?
Every Sunday.
Every Sunday. Because whatever he says to you, pops at the back, whatever he says to you, he say you are healed, you are healed.
Yes.
If he say that you are about to be blessed in 7 days, you hold on to that promise, amen. Don't let Satan manipulate you. Don't let the AIDS and the situation manipulate you. Because when the time comes, the doors will automatically open. Because when the doors open, you will know that the hand of the Lord has not been sold. Year, I want to tell our preachers and singers, whoever you are, and you, wherever you might be in life, the Bible says, iron sharpen iron. You gotta look for people that can iron you. You can't be an eagle and your friends are chicken. For one reason. The reason why I'm saying to you this, because sometimes we have a blessing, sometimes we have a promise that we're holding on to, but your people that you are associated to, they don't believe in that. They don't believe it can come to pass. They will look at you and say, hey, you're crazy. Every year you come with the same story. How many of you got friends and family like that? Put up your hand and be honest. You tell them I'm writing a book. They say, no, man, you didn't go and study for this. You tell them the Lord's going to use me in the lesson. No, Corey, I don't think you're ready. The devil is a liar. This is your year. We're not going to just be at one place. The Bible said when the hand of the Lord came upon Elijah, he sent him from Mount Carmel and put him at the front gate of Jezreel. Speed will happen when the anointing kicks in.
Amen.
You can be now in Cedarville, but in a moment from now you can be in heaven.
Amen.
Suddenly, the Holy Ghost came upon them.
Amen.
This year the Bible says, do not sit in the council of the ungodly. Do not sit with people that manipulate your faith. Do not sit with people that have a poor mindset. Because if you have a poor mindset, you have a poor pocket.
Amen. Amen.
But the Bible says, when you sit yourself from the council of the ungodly, whatever a blessed man do, Psalm 1, amen, he shall prosper.
Amen.
Right now, whatever you will do during this year, and whatever he say to you, do it. You amen. Just do it.
Amen.
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 Amen. So Jesus, whatever comes out of the mouthpiece of Jesus,
amen.
Just do it.
Amen.
Just do it.
Amen.
So I don't know where you are right now. I even don't even care. Because Jesus don't care. He cares where you're going. I said the other day, you gotta taste your future and say goodbye to your history.
Amen.
You gotta taste your destiny. goodbye to my past. This year you're gonna need to be willing to forgive people. Willing to leave the lots behind. There's certain family and relatives and even people that you're associated, you gotta push them to the side. Because for one reason, if they're not for you, they are against you.